All right, let's talk habits. I just finished reading Better Than Before by Gretchen Rubin, and a lot of it is about, it's about habits. So one of the things that this is what we'll go over today is triggers. So triggers are the things that create your ifs. So what do I mean by if? If all of your ifs. This is what I mean. There are your ifs in the phrase if this, then that, which is also an online app that lets you connect different services. So I was trying to think about this and how it applied to like our minds and bodies. So there are a lot of things where with the online service, it'd be like if I post to Instagram, then back up the image to Dropbox. So if this is post to Instagram and that is back up the image. With our minds, this is what the trigger is. Here are some examples. If I open up Netflix, then I tend to eat. Sometimes I eat rectangular pizza. If I get a notification on my phone, then I enter a black hole. How come? Well, it turns into a slot machine sometimes, so you can just keep refreshing your feeds and kind of get stuck there, and all of a sudden you're on your couch for an hour and you're not even watching anything or reading anything, you've just been staring at your phone. In high school, a lot of times we would play basketball, so if we play basketball, then we would go to McDonald's to go get dinner, post-workout meal, and it's something I still do today where after a workout I'll just gorge on food. How could I fix that? Well, let's say gorging on food is the that part and it's bad. It's something, or at least it's something I don't want to keep doing. So, I try to identify my trigger. I try to figure out what the this is. When I figure out the this, once I recognize, like, oh, I always overeat after a workout, then instead I can change McDonald's to a healthy salad now that I'm an adult and I can make that decision. Where maybe I wouldn't be able to do that in high school because a salad costs like $12, which is half a week's allowance. Another example. If I get the notification, then, and in this case, I can identify that trigger, and I actually have the option of just stopping the trigger altogether by disabling the notification for an app I don't really want to lose all my time in. So that's just a quick overview of how you can look at triggers for your habits and treat it kind of in this programming sense of if this, then that. So going back over that, one, identify your triggers. Then you have some options there. You can replace the action after you recognize the trigger for it. Or you can change the trigger altogether and just disable it. And in the next video, I'll talk about using triggers to build good habits. So if you want to start a good habit, then it's important to kind of tack it onto a trigger that you already have. So when I wake up, you already brush your teeth. Maybe you use the brushing teeth trigger to also drink a glass of water. And that's a step towards this idea in Better Than Before of being mindful while you're building the habit until it's mindless. And that's when it is actually a habit. And that's all I had. Thanks a lot.